Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let's take a look at using SharePlay to share your screen and other things between two iPhones. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So SharePlay is a new feature enabled in iOS 15.1 that allows you to share your screen with another person over FaceTime. So instead of seeing you through the camera, you can actually share your screen and some other things as well. And sharing your screen can be very useful. All right, so this is a little difficult to show because you can't screen record while you're doing SharePlay. There's probably too much going on, so they've disabled that. So the only way for me to do this is to capture using a camera two iPhone screens. So it's not going to look great, but hopefully be able to see what's going on. Now, let's go and make a FaceTime call from one to the other. So I'm going to start with this one right here, and we'll make a FaceTime video call. And the other one will pick up. MACMOST demo, FaceTime. Now I've turned off both microphones so we don't get feedback, and both are just sitting on my desk, just staring straight up at a camera and my iPad and a whole bunch of other things. So you can see the ceiling, you can see my hand if I wave. Now, we're on FaceTime, so that's all fine and good. Now let's do some SharePlay screen sharing. So I'm going to share the screen from this iPhone to this one. So what I'm going to do is go up to the top here, and you can see my FaceTime controls. This is the new control here for sharing my screen. And I'll tap that, and that starts the screen sharing. Now on the other one, the video goes away. So you can only do video or screen sharing one at a time. So you just see the initials there or their avatar, and then you see the screen sharing there. There's nothing to show because this is still on FaceTime. So let's go and move away from FaceTime, and now you can see the screen right there. Let's tap this to enlarge it. So the one on the right is the one showing its screen, and then this one here is the one seeing the screen. So you can now do whatever you want. A really useful thing would be to go and show photos. And you can show photos here, you can zoom in, you can go through and show somebody your vacation pictures, whatever you want to do. You could do other things. You could go to the web, for instance, and show a web page if you want. Really, you just show about anything that you want. You could show maps, for instance. You could show news articles. And of course, you could just show the other person what's going on your iPhone. If you're having trouble, the other person could be helping troubleshoot that trouble. So you could be showing them what's going on and they could be watching. Notice that you will still see their video right here. And you can move this around and throw it off to the edge, bring it up, and it goes off to either edge like that. So you can get it out of the way. You can make it larger and put it wherever you want. So you can use it all sorts of different ways. And here, all you see is this little initials or avatar there. So you can do the same thing here. There's not much point to it. You can move it off to the side to get it out of the way. And this is also how you would get back to FaceTime here. So you then have your controls. And you can then end the screen sharing up here by tapping this button, or the other person could also go bring back FaceTime and then end screen sharing from there. And when you do so, notice your camera doesn't automatically turn on, at least not in this version. So you have to tap here to bring your camera back so the other person can see you again. Now the other type of SharePlay isn't screen sharing, but just sharing music or videos. And there's really nothing you need to do that. I could go in this iPhone, for instance, exit FaceTime, and you can see I still see the video of the other person. And I could go to the music app and I could play a song. And now that person's going to see this notification here and they could tap it and now it'll play for them as well. And you can see here at the bottom, even though our apps are showing different things in the main part of the music app, the playback is the same. So I have complete control over it here and you can see paused playback. I could also go to a video app, like for instance here in the TV app, and play and replace the existing SharePlay with some video. And then here on the other side you can see it come up and they're actually be in sync. And I could take it full screen, turn my phone to the side, and all of that. Either one of us can control the playback. See how I just paused there? And I could scrub forward here. And if I tap here, I can go back into FaceTime, and up here to the top I can end SharePlay completely. Like that. So really for sharing your screen you have that special button you can press, but for things like music or TV you just play that media. And if you're doing that during a FaceTime call, it'll attempt to SharePlay to the other person. And that's it. It works pretty easily as long as you have two iPhones or iPads that have iOS 15.1 or newer. You can go iPhone to iPhone, iPhone to iPad, but you can't yet go to a Mac or from a Mac. So hopefully that'll come in an update pretty soon. So give it a try. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.